Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Denarians on the go and in the know. Today is December 15th, 2019. Please like, subscribe, and share to help support our channel. Check out the 12 Days of Christmas sale. Use the promo code THEDENARIAN and receive an additional $10 off the full Unleash Planner. Get your favorite Denarian the sense of security he or she deserves for Christmas. It is worth its weight in gold. Get your copy today. Time is running out. Stay informed and stay alert. And know that today we are one day closer than yesterday. I would like everyone to know, due to new YouTube policies, some channels are being deleted. If for some reason this channel gets taken down, you can still follow me on both Facebook and Twitter. The links to both platforms are in the description below. I will see you there. I also post articles of interest throughout the day on both those platforms. Some do not make it on here, due to censorship issues. With that out of the way, let's get started. First article of interest for today, in the document. Abdul Mahdi confiscates the powers of his office and the cabinet secretariat to issue directives. Today, resigned Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi issued a bureau order that included directing his office and the secretariat of the cabinet not to issue or direct any book to ministries before it was presented exclusively to him. And, from the scene of the sit-in, five candidates to succeed Abdul Mahdi and the collapse of the agreement to assign the Sudanese, take a good look at the second one in. Yes, it's Dr. Shabi B. He has my vote. Next article of interest. Al-Fatlawi, parliamentary moves to find a legal way out that enables the caretaker government to vote on the budget. On Sunday, the MP from the Al-Fatah Alliance Fatal Al-Fatlawi revealed that he was moving to find a legal way for the caretaker government to vote on the budget and send it to the council to pass it. Al-Fatlawi said to Information that if the budget is postponed to the new government after its formation and then sent to parliament, the matter will be complicated greatly, which will delay it until 2020. He added that there are parliamentary movements in cooperation with the legal authorities and the federal court to find a legal way for the caretaker government to vote on the budget and send it to the House of Representatives. He explained that the legal procedure is to consider the budget among the daily matters that the caretaker government can manage, as it includes salaries and other necessary things. Next article of interest. Deputy, the President of the Republic withdrew the candidacy of the Sudanese for his rejection of the demonstrators. On Sunday, MP Amjad Al-Yukabi confirmed that the President of the Republic withdrew the nomination of Mohammed Shia'a al-Sudani to head the Council of Ministers. Al-Yukabi said, "The Iraqi street delivered a message to the President of the Republic, Barham Saleh, and the political blocs that the party candidate for the presidency of the Council of Ministers cannot be passed because of the failure of the current political class." He added, "The information that we possess indicates that the President of the Republic withdrew the candidacy of Mohammed Shia'a al-Sudani as a result of the rejection he faced from the Iraqi street, calling on the President of the Republic to choose an independent figure who is acceptable in society and political blocs." On Sunday, the deputy for the Al-Fatah Coalition, Hanan Kato, confirmed that the passage of former minister Mohammed Shia'a al-Sudani to the post of prime minister is only political, while it is likely that another person with the support of the demonstrators will be nominated. Next article of interest. Kurdish forces meet Monday to determine their position on the new government and reveal options for their alliances with the Shiite blocs. President of the Kurdistan region Nekhervan Barzani, on Sunday, December 15, 2019, invited all political forces to hold a meeting with the president of the region, tomorrow, Monday, to discuss the current situation in Iraq. The invitation included discussing how the Kurds would stand on the nomination of a new prime minister in the federal government, and what happened to the agreement between the region and Baghdad regarding salaries and the budget, and the consequent political alliances with the Shiite forces and their options for resolving the position of the next prime minister, taking into consideration the pressures American practices on Kurdish leaderships, and the special interests that can be achieved for the Kurds, most notably financial agreements. It is scheduled that the President of the Republic, Barham Saleh, will present, in the coming hours, a candidate to head the government in place of Abdul Mahdi, who resigned on December 1. According to informed Kurdish sources, the meeting will focus on supporting a specific candidate that guarantees the Kurds their gains. The sources said, Barzani and his two deputies, Mustafa Sheikh Ja'afar and Mustafa Syed Kaderer, are scheduled to hold a meeting with the various Kurdish political forces on Monday, 16 December 2019 in the city of Erbil. She explained that an invitation was sent today to all political forces to hold a meeting with the president of the region to discuss the current situation in Iraq and to nominate a new prime minister in the federal government in addition to the agreement between the region and Baghdad regarding salaries and the budget. According to the same sources, the Kurdish blocs in the Iraqi parliament agreed to share positions among themselves in the next government, confirming that an agreement had been reached to demand three ministries in the new government, including finance and justice. Next article of interest, parliamentary legal, political blocs will resolve technical differences in the electoral law within 2 days. The Parliamentary Legal Committee revealed today, Sunday, the most prominent political differences over the election law, while it was suggested that the law be approved within the next 2 days. A member of the Parliamentary Legal Committee, Deputy Rashid Al-Azawi, told Al-Akhbaria that the political blocs have not yet found satisfactory solutions to pass the House of Representatives election law, but they can be reached within the next 2 days. Noting, the differences on the law are technical and not on the basis of the law. He added, the most prominent differences are about multiple constituencies in one constituency, as well as about individual nominations and lists. Noting, some blocs see the need for elections to be in accordance with multiple constituencies and with an individual nomination. Al-Azawi continued, but there are those who oppose this opinion for several reasons, including the failure to demarcate the administrative boundaries of some of the districts, as well as the overlap of administrations between the districts in the provinces, as well as it needs a long time to hold early elections because it requires the commission to update the voter records according to the system of multiple constituencies, and this makes it difficult to hold early elections, especially since the new commission does not have enough experience, so it also needs time because all managers will be dismissed at the level of divisions, people, and even generals, and others from outside the commission will be appointed. A member of the committee explained, as for the opinion that goes toward the single electoral district and the nomination of lists, he believes that this system will facilitate the process of holding early elections and a short period because it will keep the voter records themselves, and there will be no updates. Noting that the Parliamentary Legal Committee hosted experts from the nation's United States and other specialized experts in the elections, as well as officials in the Ministry of Planning who specialize in the administrative boundaries of the district and the population registry, as well as some officials of the High Electoral Commission, for the purpose of arriving at a final version of the law. Like, subscribe to be alerted as more articles of interest unfold and be sure to find me on Facebook and Twitter. Take advantage of the 12 days of Christmas sale before it's over. Use the promo code THEDENARIAN and receive an additional $10 off the full unleashed version. Lock in your deal today. The link is in the description below. Stay informed and stay alert. Knowledge is power. And know that today we are one day closer than yesterday. Over and out for now, THEDENARIAN.